Good day, friends. Our mission today is to find the waterfalls. We are told there's many on the old Columbia Highway. So we're going to put the top down and take this baby out for a ride. We're going to find them. Who, you don't know what else you'll find. Who knows? There might be a popo out there too. So let's go search and see what we can find.
Morning, YouTubers. This is Jim and Terry. Old geezers going out on a long holiday, one-day trip out to the Columbia Gorge and heading east. So we're going to share some of the stuff that we see out there in Multnomah Falls and some of the cool things that make the Columbia Gorge neat, and at the same time see if we can find a couple places that interest us to do future YouTube videos. So we're off to breakfast at Biscuits. Good place. Hope they hear this. Anyway, gonna go to Biscuits and then we're gonna hit the road. Well, if you can't tell, we're actually in our Mustang convertible getting ready to head out to the gorge. So stay tuned and we'll show you some beautiful scenery today. We're on historic Highway 30. Also known as the old highway to us people that live in the neighborhood.
Just about to ground point. You can see the road's pretty windy and pretty narrow. The old style guardrails. And honestly, you get past them guardrails, it's a long ways down there. But anyway, Crown Point is coming up, along with a spectacular view of the Columbia River.
Here I am. Jim says I need to talk a little bit on this roundabout trip that we're doing. So we're going to go past a couple of the waterfalls that are down through this old highway, which are very pretty. So if you ever have a time to drive out this way, stop at the waterfalls and take them all in. They're all beautiful. Falls that we were just at is called Lateral Falls, and there'll be about three or four more before we get to the well-known Multnomah Falls. So hopefully she's got some water running down her. It hasn't been very wet, so there's not too much drippage. And if you're a motorcycle enthusiast, this road is perfect for it because it's all windy and a little narrow, but it's a beautiful ride. Now we're on the approach to see Multnomah Falls. this little town here has a lot of the Indians that sell their fish. They have the best ice cream, little parlor down here. Self-served ice cream. There's always a big line too. But it's just this quaint little small town that, nice little place to visit. Walk the little shops. And if you're ever out this way, you definitely have to stop at the ice cream shop. And we're coming up on it now. And there's already a line for people for their ice cream. And it is only 11:30. So there the line starts. And at times it goes all the way up the road. Best little ice cream shop. Soft served. And there's the line starting early. In the evening, it goes past this white sign up here with people waiting to get in. But that's a quaint little town, Cascade Locks. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
So we got our peaches, got some cold water, sitting in the orchard, and getting ready to head back to the homestead.
Well, folks, another successful mission. We did find the falls and a few other things. If you liked our ride today, let us know. Subscribe or comment. Or you can hit that little bell that goes ding, 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 and they'll let you know the next time we're doing an adventure. Have a great day, because I know we will. Hasta la vista, baby.